What's up, y'all? Welcome back to another video. Now, in this video, we're going to talk about how to go about building business credit in this new year, okay? Now, the reason why I decided to shoot this video is because I think I see a lot of people who are kind of going through the basic strategies or the kind of what's been set in stone, the strategy that's always been done. And I kind of see where they're coming from, but I think there's a few different nuances that I'm doing that have worked pretty well for me that I'd like to share with you guys, okay? So if that's something that interests you, be sure that you hit the subscribe button down below so you catch any of my other credit videos as I go deeper into this. But make sure you also stay tuned so you don't miss what I'm about to talk in this one. Now, when it comes to actually doing business credit, I really look at it as really three steps. You can say four depending on how complex that you're trying to get. But I think they're really steps that, you know, you're going to be able to do over time. Okay. I don't want to sell you this dream to tell you that, you know, if you follow these steps, you're going to be able to get business credit by next Monday or next week, whatever it is. Right. But I do want to help you understand that, you know, it's going to be a process, but it's a process that you can follow and be able to get to an end result. Right. Having access to capital that you can use to grow your business. Okay. Now, first step, the most important step that people typically mess up, and I even had a slip up on it. For those of you guys who have been watching my building a business credit series where I'm doing building the business credit myself, you guys probably saw that I had made a mistake with this as well. One thing you want to do is make sure that you're setting up your business information correctly. Okay. Now, this is very important. You know, I'll link down below to some resources, not only the video that I shot talking about how I was setting mine up, but also a video about going more in depth about, you know, how you can get a phone line, because you're gonna need things like a phone, you know, address. You're gonna need a business address. You're gonna want a professional email. You're gonna want a website, all that stuff. I shot a video breaking all that stuff down, but you're gonna wanna make sure that you have all that information down correctly, okay? This is very important because what I recommend and what I've started doing after I had the little mishap I had is writing down exactly what all that information is. So, you know, I have one, basically like a document that I can look at if I ever need to, you know, if I'm filling out any type of application, I'm literally copy pasting the information and I don't type it in anymore, just to avoid any type of errors. Because what can happen is you might mistype something, or you might use, maybe you have different phone numbers that you've been using, you're mixing phone numbers, whatever it is. Maybe you're typing your business name in differently on different forms, and all that stuff can cause you not to have accounts reporting on your credit that should be. Okay. So what I did is I made sure to write it down in a notepad, basically a document, that way I can have all that information exactly as it should be. And I'm just copy pasting it into different applications, so there should never be any errors in reporting. Okay. Now, once you've done that, you can set up business accounts with the credit bureaus, the business credit bureaus. I set one up with Duns & Bradstreet at the beginning. You can do that, or you can just wait until once your accounts start reporting, they should automatically generate accounts for you. But I've set up one with Duns & Bradstreet, and I believe I set up one with one of the other two, which is Experian Business and Equifax Business. You can go ahead and set it up with them again if you want, or just let it automatically happen. Either one works. But again, important, make sure all your information going forward that you're entering is 100% identical. Okay. So I copied all that information. Even when I set up the Duns & Bradstreet, the DNB, when they gave me my Duns number, I literally copied that and put it into that document. That way I'm just copying and pasting it every time, and I'm not like hunting down for it, or, you know, typing it in correctly because I'm trying to remember it off the top of my head, things like that. Once you got that set up, that's kind of like laying the groundwork, right? Laying down the foundation. You've got the foundation set up. Next, you want to get into vendor accounts. Okay. Now, the reason why is it's kind of like a low hanging fruit. This is going to be things that they're really just net term accounts. Okay. For specific types of vendors, or, you know, brands, if you will. Okay. Now, what net terms means is just means like they're giving you a certain amount of time to pay your bill. So to look at it from like a personal credit type of aspect, it would be like, imagine like you ordered something from Amazon and Amazon told you, hey, you can pay anytime within the next 30 days for your order, right? Instead of you having to pay immediately whenever you're actually at checking out, net terms just means, you know, these companies are allowing your business, right? Whatever vendor or brand that you're using is allowing you to pay over time, or not over time, excuse me, is allowing you to pay before a certain amount of time in the future. So if it's a net 30 account, right, you have net 30 terms, then that means that the day that they invoice you, you have 30 days to pay. You don't have to pay that immediately, okay? So this is great for improving your cash to cash cycle times, which you guys have heard me talk about often. If you haven't, check out my other business credit videos where you're gonna see me talk a lot more about this. But the idea is, you wanna make sure that you're paying on time, right? It's very, very important that you, not even on time, you need to pay before it's due. You wanna make sure that you're paying before the due date, okay? Now, I have a little graphic. It's about your Paydex score, which is through Dun & Bradstreet. Now, your Paydex score, you'll see when I throw that graphic up that, you know, to get the highest Paydex score, which is basically just means it's really just about your payment history, right? To get the highest Paydex score, you would have to pay before your due date, right? So, you know, by you just paying on time, right, you paying whenever that actual bill is due, you're going to be at an 80, which 80 is good. You don't want to be lower than an 80, but I would say try to be as high as possible as you can be, right? So at least try to get into the 90s, you know, just paying early. Okay. Now, one thing I will also mention is that's one thing that I found really interesting about business credit as opposed to personal credit, right? Personal credit, they're looking at all different aspects, right? How much of your credit are you using? How long have you had your credit? So on and so forth. Really, what's most important when it comes to business credit is they want to see that you're making payments on time. Okay, it's not, you know, you could owe $100,000, but as long as you're not missing payments, then it's good, right? You're in the green, you're good to go. Okay, so that's kind of the stuff that you want to keep in mind, keep in the back of your head. Okay, now a few vendors that I've looked at, just a few to mention real quick, is Uline, Quill, Crown Office Supplies. There's a few other ones. I think it's Sumo Office Supplies mentioned as well. I shot a video on my, what I think are the top Net 30 vendors. Great ones to start with whenever you're just starting to get into business credit. I'll link to that video down below so you can take a look as well. But those are going to be pretty much the ones I think are the easiest hanging fruit, right? There's clearly or obviously a lot more than that, but those are good ones to start with. Others that I'm actually thinking about applying for myself, right? Depending on when you're watching this video, I might have already applied for it. Is going to be things like Amazon's Net 45 terms account, as well as some more office supply company net terms accounts, okay? And the reason just being is because it makes sense for my business. That's one thing I do want you guys to understand. You don't need to get net terms from everybody or try to get a bunch of net term accounts. Like, obviously, you need to have a certain amount, like, I'd say like 3 to 5, but try to find ones that work, you know, like that are gonna help you for whatever industry that you're trying to get into. Don't look at it as you just trying to get credit. Look at it as like, you know, you're trying to build a business and the credit's gonna help you grow faster. Okay, so start looking at making partnerships, right? Working with vendors that are actually in your niche or whatever industry you're trying to get into, because you're gonna be able to leverage them to grow even faster. Now, some vendor accounts, they're not gonna actually report to any of the credit reporting agencies. The ones I mentioned previously, they do, but some vendor accounts don't. But they, you know, they can still be beneficial for you depending on what you're looking to get into with your business, because they can still be used for trade references, okay? That's another thing that you can leverage, especially whenever you're trying to get credit from another company. Maybe they'll ask you for references before they extend credit to you, okay? So, and again, they can also help with cash flow issues, right? Back to that cash on cash, cash to cash cycle time thing that I mentioned earlier. That's the idea, is you're not just getting these, you know, yes, you want business credit, but these can also help you grow your business, right? Vendor, even though it's just net terms, right? You can only use that credit at that specific vendor. It still can be beneficial. Now, the next step that people are going to mention is getting revolving accounts. And I think this is an important step. I think that there is a lot of revolving accounts that you can get. I think it's a lot harder to get revolving accounts just because, you know, you're getting for a business, more than likely they're going to ask you for like personal guarantees and things like that. You can still get them. One thing that I did realize is like the field is, or the, you know, the landscape is really changing, right? I went ahead and got a secured card as well as a fintech card. And those are the first two credit cards that I got. Well, one's technically a charge card that I got. And they both report to the major credit bureaus, okay? So I'm good on that aspect. Now, one is the Wells Fargo secured card. And the reason I did that is because I wanted to have a big bank reporting on my credit report, okay? And that's the benefit that I get from the Wells Fargo business card, okay? And I'm literally have Wells Fargo, one of the largest banks in the US, who's showing that they've extended credit to me, okay? So I have those guys, and I got a fintech card, which is Divvy. And the great thing about them is now I have another credit card reporting, And they're, you know, now it's showing that people, when people look, they're gonna see that I have a, I'm running a business and I'm acquiring credit and I'm using the credit, but I'm not, you know, blowing the credit out. Okay, so I think that's where the real benefit is gonna come. You know, I'm not missing any payments. I'm making sure I'm paying on time with all that stuff, and everything from there can go smoothly. Now, if you want to know more about those two cards, I've shot videos on the Wells Fargo card as well as the Divvy card. I'm gonna link to both of them down below for you to check out. Both great cards, in my opinion. I think they're both really useful, not only for building your business credit, but one actually thing about the Wells Fargo card that I will tell you is it has a graduation track. So for those of you guys who come from my personal credit videos, you know that I love any type of secured card that has a graduation track. It gets an automatic boost in my rankings, right? And the reason is because eventually that card can turn into an unsecured card, meaning now I'm showing on my credit report an unsecured card from a big bank, okay? And I think that's a game changer. And besides that, I shot a video as of the Divvy card as well. And Divvy card is great because it has a whole platform and I'm able to issue out virtual cards and kind of, I can move that, the credit that they gave me, I can move it across different cards on their platform. So really unique, new fintech company, a fairly new fintech company that you can check out. I shot a video on before as well. Now the final step, the step that a lot of people don't mention, but you know, something that I'm looking at and actually still learning about is the getting bank lines of credit as well as bank loans, okay? Now I think that's kind of like the final step, and once you get to that point, you're pretty established and on, you know, you're pretty good standing. But you know, I think a lot of people just kind of focus on the credit cards and they kind of overlook this final step, okay? Now me, the way I look at it is like, imagine instead of you having a credit card that you have to swipe and stuff, being able to, you know, pull money from a line of credit whenever you want, right? You know, having that type of banking relationship where you know, if you need to, you can get a loan from a bank, you know, almost, I don't want to say no questions asked, but a very easy access to cash. And I think that really comes from, you know, if I had to guess, it has to come from, you know, having really great banking relationships. So it's a situation where you've been using that same bank for years and years and years, which that's why I think that it's important for you to be strategic about the bank you're using for, you know, your checking account, for example, right? And then the more business you're bringing to them, the more willing they're going to be to extend you other types of credit, okay? So be strategic in what kind of banks you're using. And also, you're gonna have to have pretty good revenue, right? So those are really, my opinion, the two biggest factors, right, that I would assume, okay? Now, some people might be wondering, like, yeah, okay, you get more credit, so on and so forth. Why are you looking into it? And to be quite honest, like, what I'm doing is, with my business, my plan, like, long-term goal is to be able to eventually just start, like, you know, buying companies in the future, right? I want to be able to, you know, acquire companies kind of like you're able to buy a real estate property, right? And I know it sounds kind of crazy, but, you know, I want to say it was like almost seven to eight years back, I listened to a talk a guy had where that's what he did, is he bought companies. And he talked about it and was kind of giving, you know, kind of a behind the scenes look at what he did, and talked about how he was really buying companies kind of like you buy a house, right? You got to put 20% down, you need this, that, the other. And he was saying how similar it was to how he bought businesses, right? Because he had built those banking relationships where they trusted him. He was able to go and, you know, buy a business and just put 20% down and the bank covered the rest of it. And then while he was growing that business, right, he would buy businesses that he knew he could, you know, grow even faster. And then he would use the revenue or the profits and the revenues he was getting to pay off that loan. Okay. So that's kind of something similar to what I'm looking to do. And so that's why I'm really looking at this final step. And I think that's really where, you know, kind of where I have my sights set. I'm always telling you guys about setting goals, and that's really the goal for me. Okay. Is getting to that. Right. And so really that's the gist of it, man. I think when it comes to building business credit, those are really the steps that you want to follow. If you want more in depth on certain sections of these, follow my building business credit series that I'm doing. Okay. I'm pretty much halfway done getting to the revolving accounts. Or excuse me, I already have some of the revolving accounts. I'm gonna get deeper into them. Getting even more of those cards and stuff like that. And I'll be able to deep dive into those and what routes I think you should go with that as well. once I start accumulating even more credit cards. But I think this is going to be a great start for anyone who's looking to build business credit, okay? This is a solid foundation that you can have, and for you to be able to just have the capital you need to be able to, you know, grow your business even faster than normal, okay? So that's going to be the gist for this video. Be sure you check out the other business credit videos that I've shot, breaking down all these, you know, going in depth and all these little nuances that I've mentioned in this video. Also, if you enjoy this video, be sure you hit the like button so we can get this video out to more people, all right? And also make sure that you hit the subscribe button down below. That way you don't miss any of my future videos, all righty? So that's going to be pretty much the gist of this video, guys. I appreciate y'all taking the time to watch. Comment down below if you have any questions, and I'll be happy to answer them. But until then, I will see you at the next one.